So we are into our fifth session. All right, what we learnt yesterday? Yes, we learnt different effects of chemical reactions, that is the properties of chemical reactions, characteristics of chemical reactions, right? After that we learnt the types of chemical reaction, but yesterday we saw only two types. First, combination reaction, and second, decomposition reaction. So let's move on to the third type of chemical reaction, and that is called displacement reaction. All right, the third type of reaction, it is called displacement reaction. All right, children, let's try to understand it. उसको थोड़ा समझने की कोशिश करते हैं विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन इररिलेवेंट एग्जांपल. एग्जांपल थोड़ा इररिलेवेंट है, बट इट विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट वेरी वेल. ऑलराइट, हियर इज वन स्टूडेंट ए एंड देयर इज अनदर स्टूडेंट बी. दे आर वेरी क्लोज फ्रेंड्स, दे ऑलवेज रिमेन टूगेदर, सो देयर इज अ स्ट्रांग बॉन्ड बिटवीन देम एंड दे आर ऑलवेज टूगेदर. Now, in the class, in your class, these are two students in your class which are very good friends and they remain bonded, they remain always together. New admission comes, children. There's new admission. Student C is new student in the class. Now, these two have strong bond because, let's say, this A helps B in many ways, or let me say A entertains B in many ways. B helps A in solving difficulties, in doing homework, but A helps B by giving him snacks, by taking him for movie. All right, receives B at home with warmth and they play games. Alright, so B is very happy with A and forms bond. Now comes C. Well, he is a newcomer in the class, correct? So, yeah, he saw that this B is very helpful, his nature is good, so I should be making friends. Being new, B approaches C. Yeah, and tries to know his history. Alright, so C starts becoming friend of B. Now, they start coming closer. What A does for B, C does much more than A for B. Alright, ये तो उसकी बाइक भी देता है चलाने के लिए. Alright, sometimes they go together. Then B drops C at home, or C की bike लेकर अपने घर चले जाता है. There is lots of things. Ice cream खिलाता है, lots, pizza, everything. In short, this C does much for B compared to A. So what happened? This bond breaks and new bond forms. Can you tell me which is the new bond? C B and A is out of that. So you can say AB plus C gives CB plus A. Are you getting me? So you can say C displaced A in AB. C displaced A. A को, C ने A को अपनी जगह से निकाल दिया. Alright? Same thing. Here C is doing more for B as compared to A. Let's say now these are substances. Substance 1 is made up of two elements A and B. Now this substance reacts with another element C. Now element C is more reactive, or substance C is more reactive than A. C is more reactive than A, then C will displace A and new substance form will be CB and A is removed out. Children, PQ plus R gives, बोलिए क्या? Q को बाहर निकाल दिया, समझो, तो PR Q को बाहर निकाल दिया. This will happen only if R is more reactive than Q. If R is more reactive than Q, then only it will happen. It will happen only if R is, okay? Suppose Q is more reactive than R, or R is less reactive than Q. Ye R isse less reactive hai. Then this will not take place. Displacement will not take place. So children, be careful. Okay? Let's see a few examples. First example. Copper sulfate. Copper sulfate. Alright? Reacts with iron. Reacts with iron. Okay, copper is Cu plus 2, sulfate is SO4 minus 2. So you got the formula, directly you may join CuSO4. This is in aqueous form. It is dissolved in water. So it is solution of copper sulfate. Reacts with iron, you know the formula, Fe. Now this is solid form. Children, here iron is more reactive than copper. Ye bhi metal hai, ye bhi metal hai. Iron metal is more reactive than copper. So, iron will displace copper in copper sulfate. Copper sulfate mein copper ko iron displace karega. Alright? So, instead of copper, now it will be iron. Iron mein ferrous aur ferric do hote hai. Here it will be ferrous. Ferrous sulfate. And what is removed out? Copper. That copper will be removed out. Alright? Ferrous Fe plus 2. Sulfate SO4 minus 2. So straight away FeSO4, which will be in aqueous form. And copper, it will be in solid form. Alright? You may balance the chemical equation, but you will find it is already in its balanced state. Alright. Now, this is an example of displacement reaction. Because iron displaces copper. This is going to happen only if iron is more reactive than copper. And here, iron is more reactive than copper. Is that clear to you? Okay. Let's see another example. Alright. HCl. Alright. Uska aqueous solution lenge. Tabhi solid ka reaction jaldi hoga. We'll treat with zinc. We will treat with zinc, which is a metal. This is hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid. Abhi to formula aa raha hai aapko. You will know the formula directly. And if you don't know, in acid, H1 ion is always present. Now this hydrochloric, you get the hint. The negative ion present here is chloride, which is Cl minus 1. Seedha join karo. Alright. Now the question is, is zinc more reactive than hydrogen? And the answer is yes. Zinc is more reactive than hydrogen. So zinc will displace hydrogen from HCl. Zinc hydrogen ko bahar karega. Let's see. So you will get zinc chloride. Zinc yahan aa jayega, so you will get zinc chloride. And zinc is Zn plus 2 and Cl is minus 1. So formula will be Zn1 Cl2, Zn, 1 Cl2, this will be in aqueous state, plus hydrogen is removed out, symbol is H, but the formula is H2, and hydrogen is gaseous form. Alright, now you may balance this chemical equation, chlorine 1, chlorine 2, so make 2 hydrogen, 1 zinc, 1 zinc. So this is a balanced chemical equation with all states also written. This dissolved in water, so aqueous zinc metal solid form. Zinc chloride is obtained, which is aqueous in dissolved form. and hydrogen gas bubbles, it will be removed out. Okay, so what you got here? Zinc chloride and hydrogen. So this is another example of displacement reaction. All right, here zinc displaces hydrogen and here iron displaces copper. So only one metal displaces another metal. Only one displacement takes place. Copper ki jagah pe iron aa gaya. So one displacement. So quite often you can call this as single displacement reaction also. Or simply we say displacement reaction, which means single displacement takes place. Because next type of reaction that we are going to see is double displacement reaction. But now the question is, children, okay, how do we know iron is more reactive than copper or zinc is more reactive than hydrogen? For that, you will have to learn by heart the activity series, or also called reactivity series of metals and non-metals. Alright, I have one trick for you to remember the activity series, yeah, reactivity series of metals and non-metals. Alright, so let's see that. Do you remember? Plus one, hyposocia. Minus one, hyclobini. Plus two, cocaprazimabapur. Minus two, SSCO. Plus three, aluminium and ferric. Minus three, phosphate. Kuch peculiar hai. It's something peculiar which you have to remember. Alright, same way, there is peculiarity here. But if you write 10 times today, and then for next 3 days, 5 times, you will learn by heart. And then every week or after 10 days, okay, for next 2 weeks, once in a week you write 3 times. And then every month, 1 time you write, and you will remember it forever. If you do this for next 3 or 4 months, finished. You will remember it forever. Yes, you will find it very strange when you hear this. Say, K-Bana. You have to write exactly how I am writing it. Capital letter, small letter. K-Bana Kamams Kamams Fanny TL Haiku Message MSG Message K-Bana Kamams Penny TL Haiku Message. K-Bana Kamams Penny TL Haiku Message. Children, this, what you find here, are metals, name of the metals. The letter will tell you. Some letters are beginning of the word of the metal. Say, suppose zinc, the symbol Zn is used. Iron, symbol Fe is used. Nickel, symbol Ni is used. Tin. Tin ka symbol hai SN, but I use the word tin, T for tin. Lead, you know the symbol is PB, but I use the first letter of its word, lead, L for lead, okay, like that. Now, I'll tell you, this is potassium, this is most reactive, this is most reactive, and this one is least reactive. Gold. G for gold. Okay. I'm writing it. Potassium is more reactive than Ba. Symbol hai. Potassium is symbol hai. K is symbol for potassium. Ba is symbol for barium. Is more reactive than Na is symbol of sodium. Is more reactive than Ca is symbol of calcium. Is more reactive than M. Magnesium. M for magnesium. Magnesium. Alright. Is more reactive than A for aluminium. Not symbol. I use the first letter of the term. Aluminium. Alright. Is more reactive than again M. This is manganese. This is manganese. Alright. Is more reactive than. Children, you might wonder. Yaha bhi M. By mistake, we may write manganese here and magnesium here. But then, uske liye bhi trick hai. M, M, A, A-G-N, अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर में जी पहले आया आएगा कि एम आएगा, इन अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर व्हाट विल कम फर्स्ट, जी और एन? यस, इन अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर जी विल कम फर्स्ट, सो मैग्नीशियम कम फर्स्ट एंड देन कम्स मैग्नीशियम, सो फर्स्ट इज मैग्नीशियम एम जी एंड दिस इज मैंगनीज एम एन, सिंबॉल सिंबॉल भी है, एम जी इज द मैग्नीशियम सिंबॉल एंड एम एन इज द मैंगनीज सिंबॉल. ऑल राइट, मोर ओके, मैंगनीज इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन जिंक, जिंक इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन आयरन, आयरन इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन निकल, इट इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन टीन, इट इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन लीड, इट इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन हाइड्रोजन, हाइड्रोजन आई एम पुटिंग इन स्क्वायर बॉक्स, इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन कॉपर, सी यू कॉपर, इट इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन एम फॉर मर्क्यूरी, एम फॉर मर्क्यूरी इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन एस फॉर सिल्वर, नॉट सल्फर, सिल्वर इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन जी फॉर गोल्ड. दिस इज द रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज दैट यू विल हैव टू रिमेंबर. द ओनली थिंग यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इज के बाना कमाम स्पेनी टीएल हाइको मैसे. प्लीज टुडे यू राइट 10 टाइम्स, ओके, टुमारो यू राइट 10 टाइम्स के बाना कमाम स्पेनी एंड देन बिलो दैट यू हैव टू राइट दिस आल्सो. ऑलराइट, नाउ इफ यू राइट सिंबॉलिकली इट इज दिस, पोटेशियम के इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन बेरियम बी ए, इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन सोडियम एन ए, इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन कैल्शियम सी ए, इज मोर रिएक्टिव देन मैग्नीशियम एम जी, is more reactive than aluminium Al, is more reactive than manganese Mn, is more reactive than zinc Zn, is more reactive than iron Fe, is more reactive than nickel Ni, is more reactive than tin, tin symbol is Sn, is more reactive than lead, the symbol is Pb, is more reactive than hydrogen, the symbol is H, I'll put in the square box, is more reactive than copper, Cu, is more reactive than mercury, the symbol is Hg, is more reactive than silver, the symbol is Ag, and it is more reactive than gold, and the symbol is Au. So, aapko ye bhi yaad rakhna hoga with symbol. Alright? So, please, aap usko screenshot le lo, ya pause karke, jara book mein copy kar lo. And please try to learn it. This is going to be very useful to you in 11th and 12th science also, which metal is reactive. And in one of the chapter, metals and non-metals chapter, we are going to study how this reactivity series is derived. All right, I'll just remove this here and say this is reactivity, or you can say activity series. All right, it's very important for you to remember. So please note down this. All right, children. Now let's see few examples where displacement will occur or not. If displacement occurs, we'll complete the equation. If displacement doesn't occur, then there won't be any reaction. All right. Here is the activity series. Here the activity series. Let's say it is, yeah, lead nitrate plus aluminium. All right, in definite conditions, we do not know conditions, we are not writing here. Actually, we should know under what condition this reaction will occur. All right, now here is salt, lead nitrate ek salt hai. और उसी सॉल्ट में लीड नाम का मेटल है. हियर इट इज लीड. ऑलराइट, एंड इट इज रिएक्टिंग विद एल्यूमिनियम. हियर इज एल्यूमिनियम. इज एल्यूमिनियम मोर रिएक्टिव देन लीड? इज एल्यूमिनियम मोर रिएक्टिव देन लीड? दिस इज मोस्ट रिएक्टिव एंड दिस इज लीस्ट रिएक्टिव. सो द रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज डिक्रीजेस. करेक्ट, एक्टिविटी डिक्रीजेस एज यू मूव फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट. So here the two circles showing aluminium and lead, which is on the right, lead, so it is less reactive, and which is on the left, aluminium, it is more reactive, left most and a right least. Okay, so aluminium is more reactive than lead. Yes, so the displacement will take place. And what you will get? This is lead nitrate. Lead nitrate. Alright, this one is aluminium. Now in place of lead, it will be aluminium. So the new substance will be aluminium nitrate. Aluminium nitrate. And what will be removed? Lead will be removed out. Plus lead. Alright. For lead, straight away you can put the formula. Aluminium. Al plus 3. Plus 3. And nitrate. NO3 minus 1. So Al1 and no need of writing 1. Al1 and NO3 thrice. This is the formula. After that you can balance it. So here, because aluminium is more reactive than lead, yes, reaction, yeah, displacement will take place. Let's see another example. Magnesium chloride. Magnesium chloride combines with, all right, I'll take copper, gives. Now look here, just pay attention. This copper, is it more reactive than aluminium? So you will have to check in the reactivity series. Where is L? Sorry, more reactive than magnesium. Where is magnesium? Here. And where is copper? Here. Right, copper is less reactive and magnesium is more reactive. Is copper more reactive? Is it more reactive? The answer is no. Answer is no. So this reaction will not take place. Copper cannot substitute magnesium. Is that clear to you? So sometimes what you will think, oh, let me write this copper chloride, CuCl2 plus magnesium will be removed out. This can never happen. Copper less reactive than magnesium, so copper cannot displace magnesium. So sometimes in the examination, they ask you this type of question. If displacement cannot take place, you will have to write here displacement will not take place because copper is less reactive than magnesium. So copper cannot displace magnesium from magnesium chloride. Is that clear to you? Okay. So we move on to the next one, and that is double displacement now. Alright. Fourth. Double displacement. Well, in double displacement, there's no need of activity series, but still I'm writing it. K bana kamams fanny TL haiku message. Alright. Why it is called double displacement? Very soon you will come to know. Calcium chloride, one salt, egg salt. The name of this salt is calcium chloride. Another salt, alright? Copper nitrate, CuNO3 twice. Another salt I have taken. The name of this salt is copper nitrate. Children, let's do this. Not write the formula. I have taken two salts. Now you know how to select salts. Do you? Positive metal or wahan se hydroxide or oxide ko chhod ke koi bhi negative le lo. You get salt. Fine. Calcium Ca plus 2. Chloride Cl minus 1. Ca Cl 2. That is the formula. Iske niche. Iske niche likhte hai. Copper nitrate, copper Cu plus 2, nitrate NO3 minus 1. Yeah, so it's the formula Cu1 NO3 twice. Cu NO3 twice. Alright. Children, yahan to single substance nahi hai, single element nahi hai. Both are salt. Okay, now see. Here the metal is calcium. Here it is. The metal is copper. Here it is. Yes, calcium is more reactive than copper. Calcium is more reactive than copper. So calcium will remove copper from there. But copper will not be alone. Copper will combine here. So calcium displaces copper and copper occupies the position of calcium. So double displacement. Calcium displaces copper and you can say copper displaces calcium. You should not say copper displaces calcium. Actually, calcium more reactive, so it displaces copper and copper occupies the position of calcium with chlorine. Are you getting me? So the reaction. Now, yeah, this ions. Aise cross kar do. Calcium nitrate. So Ca1NO3 twice. Ca1NO3 twice. Plus Cu1Cl2. Cu1Cl2. Then you may balance the chemical equation. Alright. Isko salt mein aqueous form mein lete hai solution. Reaction karne. Both are dissolved in water and then they are reacted. This is also obtained in aqueous form. Alright. Okay. Dissolved form mein lete. Kabhi kabhi insoluble form mein bhi mil sakta hai. And what is that insoluble substance called? Precipitates. Correct. Okay. Let's take another example of double displacement. Alright. I'll remove this. AgNO3. Silver nitrate. Silver nitrate. That is the salt. Plus, let's take NaCl. Sodium chloride. Most common salt. Sodium chloride. That is NaCl. Now, ye dono ko dekho. Metal is sodium and metal is silver. Sodium kahan hai? Yaha. Silver, S for silver here. Yes, sodium is more reactive than silver. Sodium is more reactive. So sodium will displace silver. And silver won't be alone. It will form bond with chlorine atom. So double displacement. Isne yahan jagali, isne yahan jagali. Are you getting me? So this is going to, okay, I'll write the ions. Ag plus 1, NO3 minus 1. Na plus 1 and Cl minus 1. Sida join karo, cross karo. Ag Cl plus 1 minus 1, so straight away it will join. And this gives NaNO3, sodium nitrate. Ye bhi aqueous form hoga, kyunki dissolved form mein lete hai. Aur yahan koi bhi, aapko undissolved form, ya insoluble substance is not obtained. So you will get them in aqueous state. Is that clear? Yadi suppose ye insoluble hota, to aapko solid likhna hota hai. And that is precipitate. And precipitate jo solid substance hamesha niche baithta hai. So with precipitate they put arrow. Here it's not the case. Alright? It is in aqueous form. Gas hota, suppose ke hydrogen. Alright? Gas ko aap upward arrow likhte hai. Gas evolves out. And precipitates settles down. Okay? Fine, understood with these two examples. So these are the two examples of double displacement. Next, we shall see redox reaction. Fine, so we move on to the next type of chemical reaction. This is the last one. Fifth, redox reaction. Now, what do you mean by redox reaction? It's a chemical reaction in which oxidation and reduction both takes place simultaneously. If both oxidation and reduction take place simultaneously in a chemical reaction, then such a chemical reaction is called redox. This RE word, RED, comes from reduction, and OX word comes from oxidation. So clear to you? Redox means reduction and oxidation taking place simultaneously in the reaction. Now the question is, what is oxidation and what is reduction? So for that you will have to remember a few things. Number one, you can say oxidation is taking place if substance lose electrons, loss of electrons, loss of electrons. If a substance, in a substance, loss of electrons takes place, you can say that substance is oxidized. That substance is oxidized. Atwa oxidation of that substance has taken place. Well, in reduction, it is simply, if it is loss of electron, here it is gain of electrons. Gain of electrons. Is that clear to you? So only one part you remember, the other part you will remember automatically. So if a substance loses electrons, then that oxidation of that substance takes place. If substance, chemical substance, compound, gains electron, then that substance is reduced. Atwa reduction of that substance takes place. There are a few more things. Second, addition of non-metal. Addition of non-metal. Addition of non-metal. This non-metal are also called electronegative elements. They are electronegative elements because non-metals have tendency to gain electrons. Okay, so don't think of this now. Why it is called non-electronegative elements? Because they have tendency to gain and become negative ion. That's why. So addition of non-metals in a substance, if non-metal is added, then oxidation of that substance has taken place. All right. Or, isko aap yaad rakho ya na rakho. Or addition of non-metal or removal of metal. Removal of metal. Metal ko aap electro पॉजिटिव एलिमेंट कहते हैं. एलिमेंट्स. इज दैट क्लियर? एडिशन ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स दैट इज इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट्स और रिमूवल ऑफ मेटल्स. यहां चिल्ड्रन उल्टा. हियर एडिशन ऑफ मेटल दैट इज इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिव एलिमेंट or removal of non-metal. Removal of non-metal, which is electronegative element. Okay. One more, children. Third, which is important for our 10th standard concept. Addition of oxygen. Addition of oxygen. If oxygen is added to the substance, that substance is oxidized. Atwa oxidation of that substance has taken place. That is what we can say. Or removal of hydrogen. Or removal of hydrogen. If oxygen is added, that substance is oxidized. Or if hydrogen is removed from the substance, that substance is oxidized. Don't get confused. I'm going to give you a short trick to remember this, children. Okay. Third one. Here, addition of oxygen. Here, addition of hydrogen. Addition of hydrogen. Or you can say removal of oxygen. Children, what you have to do is to remember only this part, not this. And from this, you can make some conclusions for reduction reaction. Okay? I'm giving you a trick. Here it is. O-I-L, oil. O for oxidation, I for is, and L for loss. So oil is loss of electrons. Oil. So O for oxidation is loss of electrons. Remember oil. Okay. O for oxidation. I for is. And L for loss. Loss of what? Electrons. Alright. So oxidation, oil. Oxidation is loss of electrons. Alright. Something is lost. No. So, should we add something?
should we add something? The answer is no. Answer is no. Because by adding something to oil, the oil will get adulterated. Whatever trick you apply, you will have to remember. Oil, add, no. Now I'm telling you. Oil, O for oxidation, I for ease, and L for loss. So oxidation is loss of electrons. Aapka pehla point aa gaya. Add what? N. N for non-metal. N for non-metal. So your second point comes. N for add, addition of non-metal. Addition of non-metal means removal of metals. That you can understand. And again, add what? O. O for oxygen. Third point. Addition of oxygen. So aapko ye yaad rakhna hai. So all the confusion of oxidation and reduction would perish. It will be removed from your mind. Is that clear to you? So what you will remember? Oil. O for oxidation, I for ease, and L for loss. So oxidation is loss of electrons, or addition of non-metal, or addition of oxygen. All right? Addition of non-metal, yeah, addition of oxygen. Is that clear to you? So in the same equation, same reaction, oxidation and reduction takes place, then such a reaction is called redox reaction. Now let's take example. Please take screenshot of this. And remember, that is very important. That will help you. Okay? Fine. Now let's see a few examples of redox reaction. Alright? Okay, first one, copper oxide, oxide of metal, reacts with hydrogen, all right, to produce copper and water. Copper oxide reacts with hydrogen to produce copper and water. All right, please pay attention. I'm not balancing or writing the state and all that. I just want to know. What is oxidized? Oxidation of which substance is taking place and reduction of which substance is taking place. Please pay attention. In the first formula, you have copper and oxygen. Correct? Copper oxide. Or copper yaha hai. Right hand side pe copper is alone. And in left hand side, copper is bonded with oxygen. Put this arrow. Copper to copper. Copper to copper. Alright, now what happened? From copper, what is gone? Oxygen is gone. Oxygen is removed. Oxygen is removed means hydrogen is added. See, if oxygen is added, then it is oxidation. Look here. If oxygen is added, then it is oxidation. But here, oxygen is removed. From copper oxide turns to copper. That means oxygen is gone. So this is reduction. This is reduction. You can say copper oxide is reduced. Copper oxide is reduced. Is that clear to you? Now look here. This is hydrogen or hydrogen wala compound here, H2O. Now you can see it was all alone hydrogen. What happened? Oxygen is added to hydrogen. Addition of oxygen. So this reaction is oxidation. And you can say hydrogen is oxidized. Hydrogen is oxidized. Please, one more thing. Don't get confused. What is reduced? Copper oxide. The substance which is reduced is called oxidizing agent. It is oxidizing agent. And the substance oxidized is hydrogen. But it is called reducing agent. Please, if the substance is reducing agent, wo khud oxidize hua hoga. If the substance is oxidizing agent, wo khud reduce hua hoga. If the substance is reduced, then that substance is oxidizing agent. If substance is oxidized, then that substance is reducing agent. Please pay attention. We are using this, simply this. Alright? So in this reaction, reduction is taking place, oxidation is taking place. So this is an example of redox reaction. Is that clear? Let's see another example. Second example, copper plus oxygen gives copper oxide. Very interesting, children. Chali. Copper and copper. So copper to copper, I'm putting an arrow. Look here. Copper alone, oxygen is added. Addition of oxygen is taking place. So this is oxidation. Oxidation. What is oxidized? Copper. Copper is oxidized. So copper is reducing agent. Is that clear? Any one mark question can be asked. Be careful. Now, look. Oxygen is here and oxygen is here. Well, oxygen mein kuch add hua hai. Addition of non-metal. Toh wo oxidation hoga. Lekin addition of copper is metal. Oxygen mein metal add hua. Can you say that? Addition of non-metal nahi. Addition of metal. So addition of metal is reduction. So this is reduction. What is reduced? Oxygen is reduced. Alright. If oxygen is reduced, it is oxidizing agent. Alright. Anything which is reduced or oxidized will be as reactants. Oxidizing agent and reducing agent will be as reactants. Nothing from products. Product mein nothing is oxidized or reduced. Be careful. Substance oxidized, you will find on left hand side of the arrow. Substance reduced, you will find on left hand side of the arrow. Nothing on right hand side. So keep that in mind. I hope you understood. So in this chemical reaction, oxidation as well as reduction is taking place. So it is redox reaction. Let's see one more example. Alright. Fine. H2S, hydrogen sulfide, reacts with chlorine. Reacts with chlorine to produce hydrochloric acid and sulfur. I'm not balancing, putting the state, alright? Fine. Hydrogen, yeah, hydrogen hai, yeah, hydrogen hai. Alright? Sulfur ki baat, hydrogen next, sulfur. Aur udhar sulfur is alone. So this is sulfur to sulfur. Alright? Sulfur, what happened? Hydrogen is removed. Ye H2S. Now sulfur is alone, so hydrogen is removed. Hydrogen is removed, not added. Addition of oxygen, oxidation. If oxygen is added, that means hydrogen is removed. So this is oxidation. Oxidation. Alright. So that means hydrogen sulfide is oxidized. That means hydrogen sulfide is reducing agent. Alright. Now look at the chlorine. Yeah. Here chlorine is there. And you can see. What is added to chlorine? Hydrogen. So addition of oxygen. Addition of hydrogen. That means not oxidation. This is reduction. Addition of oxygen. Then oxidation. But this is addition of hydrogen. So it is reduction. Yaha, removal of hydrogen, removal of addition of oxygen is actually removal of hydrogen. That's why it is oxidation. Yeah, so chlorine is reduced and same chlorine is oxidizing agent. Clear to you? Understood the redox reaction? So children, now we have seen all five types of chemical reaction. First one, combination reaction. Second, decomposition reaction. Third, displacement reaction. Fourth, double displacement reaction. And fifth, redox reaction. Quite often they say there are four types of reaction. First, combination. Second, decomposition. Third, they say displacement only. And fourth, redox. Displacement means single displacement and double displacement. Is that clear to you? Fine.